Hey, welcome back to Ask Matt, where I answer your questions on the internet. The latest question came in from someone named Chris, who said, "Hi, Matt. My work doesn't provide any sort of mentoring or professional development. Do you have any resource or third parties that can offer this sort of one-on-one guidance?" So there's a couple different ideas I have about how this happens, but it turns out there's actually something, I've never used it before, but I've heard of it, called codementor.io. And what codementor is a place where you go find people who say, "Hey, I'm expert level at this thing, pay me money and I'll be your mentor, little bits and pieces here in the time." So I've never tried it. I can't say that it's amazing, but I've heard at least one person say that they've used it and appreciate it. So that's one opportunity. There's also been folks in the past, like Phil Sturgeon, who will actually just, you know, charge you $200 an hour or $200 a half an hour, something like that, to Skype chat. So one option is also to reach out to people who you'd love to have them be your mentor and say, "Hey, can I pay you money to mentor me?" But one of the things that I've often recommended to people is that a lot of people who are people who you might want to mentor you might also have open source projects. And a good way to get free conversation, free input, and free code review from somebody who you look up to is by contributing your time to their open source projects. Because for example, every single time somebody does a pull request to one of my open source projects, I give them notes, I give them a code review, I thank them for their work, and I notice their name. So there's these sort of interactions that are happening. And I mean, for example, for OnRamp, OnRamp.dev that we're building, we have a chat with dozens of people who I might not know otherwise, but because they're in there trying to contribute to OnRamp, I have more sense of who they are. And when they work on OnRamp projects, then I have a sort of like a, "Hey, I'm giving you direction for how to think through this thing. I'm giving you input on your pull requests and stuff like that." So I would say that there's a little bit of a free mentoring relationship that you get out of contributing to somebody's open source project. So I think those are the biggest ones. I do think that there's a lot to be said from more natural mentoring relationships that come from meeting people in social settings. So going to conferences is a really great space for this. And you know, you meet people there and you connect with them and you might meet people that you look up to. But I do think that probably the easiest one for people to do for free is to get involved in open source projects. And if you want to pay money, I would probably check out CodeMentor, or I would probably, again, just reach out to somebody you respect and just say, "Hey, what would it cost to, you know, don't, hey, can I get an hour of your time for free? No. Can I buy you a $6 coffee? No. Can I pay you hundreds of dollars?" Like, imagine if someone is, you know, a potential mentor, like, what would they make on a normal half hour engagement? You know, what is their hourly rate? Probably over $150 an hour. So consider whether you can save up enough to actually have some regular chats with them, or at least one where you can kind of ask these questions. So I hope that helps, and keep sending the questions over. See you next time.